Today I shall be talking about the Rohingya crisis. I'll be covering majorly in four parts, namely who these Rohingyas are, what is the background to this crisis, why do people link Islamic terror to the Rohingya refugee crisis, and what is India's stand. To begin with, who these Rohingyas are. Rohingyas are basically Indo-Aryan race. They speak a language akin to Bengali, and they have settled around in the region of Arakan, which is now called Rakhine, and concentrate majorly in the bordering district of Burma and Bangladesh and the coastal region of Arakan. The history can be traced way back to 15th century, where they were first known to have come and settled in this region. Britishers and the Portuguese got them as slaves to this area. The Rohingya Muslim nationalists, however, claim that they came here with the Arab traders and they trace their origin to the Arab lands. However, there is no historically convincing evidence to that effect. Now, what is the background to this crisis? Well, it was during the World War II when Rohingya sided the British, while the Aboriginal Rakhine Buddhists sided the Japanese. In 1942, there was a massive communal violence between the British armed Rohingyas of Victor Force. Now, what is this present Rohingya crisis? This present Rohingya crisis, the refugee crisis, is all after October 2016. The Rohingya terrorists attacked the Burmese military post, the police post, and the police counteraction, and there started the story of Rohingya refugees. So these Rohingya refugees are also referred to as the boat people. Over past 2.5 weeks, as per the United Nations, approximately 313,000 Rohingyas have fled Arakans. And this is all because of Burma military's Scorch and Earth campaign that they have unleashed. There are reports of rampant mass murders, killings, looting, rape and arson by the Burmese military. People are raising question over the silence of the Nobel Prize winner Aung San Suu Kyi, who has very little control yet over the military, and military rules the roosts. There is a Pakistani and the Saudi dimension. These guys are busy funding the terrorist organization of the Rohingyas, and they are fueling Islamic insurgency in this region. Now, what is India's stand? In India, there are approximately 40,000 Rohingya refugees. They are largely settled in the state of Assam, Bengal, and Jammu and Kashmir, the Jammu region. The people of Jammu region say that settling of Rohingya refugees in their area could change the demographic balance, which is in favor of Jammu Hindus. Government of India feels that they are a major security risk, because there is a high possibility that many of these Rohingya refugees have been radicalized by the Saudi and the Pakistani intelligence agents, and these people can be of great potential threat to the internal security of India. So as a result, they say that we want to deport the Rohingyas. United Nations Human Rights Commission criticized India over its stance over Rohingya refugees, and the government of India thereafter modulated their stance, and now they say that they will be deported only once the situation in the Arakan become conducive for their return to their homes, and they will be treated as per the norms way India has been treating all other refugees. The Prime Minister of India, Mr. Modi, was criticized when he visited Burma very recently after Chinese visit, that he did not speak for the Rohingya Muslims. On the contrary, cited the narrative of Burmese military that we will uphold the territorial integrity of Burma and we support its fight against terrorism. This was all criticized in India, especially the Muslims. There were protests on the streets and in the social media by the Indian Muslims, who, going by the Muslim Ummah norms, the Muslim nationalism, they have been protesting in India, and some of the secular parties are also supporting them. Politics before national security, Muslim Ummah over national security is the name of the game as far as these people are concerned. Chinese have also supported the Burmese in their effort to safeguard their territorial integrity, and this makes it a very catch-22 situation for India. The strategic space in Burma that is up for grabs, because Burmese want Indians to invest, to counterbalance the Chinese predominance in their landscape. If India does not support the Burmese cause, probably in the long run, India stands to lose. The losses are greater than the benefit. Now we are a very practical nation, and we cannot afford practicalism over idealism. It is very sad that Rohingya Muslims are being prosecuted and there are gross human rights violations. Any human being, for that matter, cannot support that. Why is it that there are no voices, there is no dissent, there is no protest in our country, forcing countries like Pakistan, the champions of the Muslim causes all across the globe, the Sunni Muslim leaders sitting in Saudi Arabia and the Shia leaders sitting in Iran? Why are they not protesting and demanding that they should all pull in the resources and support the Rohingya refugees scattered all across in the Southeast Asian region? Rohingya refugee crisis is indeed a very major humanitarian crisis. There is no denying the fact. No human being can deny or take a backseat when he sees these kind of miseries that are being unleashed over these poor people of Arakan by Burmese military. But we should also understand that despite all that, there is a huge security risk that is related to these refugees. Very unfortunate, but that's the fact. That is the truth. We cannot ignore the security factors because of the humanitarian crisis. We as responsible citizens of this country should strengthen the government's stand as far as security is concerned, and also the humanitarian stand that the government has taken in providing humanitarian aid under Op Insaniyat to Bangladesh. We should think beyond the communal lines. It's not a Muslim issue. Rohingya should not be treated as a Muslim issue. It is a humanitarian crisis with security dimensions. Nation comes first, always and every time. This should be the motto. Thank you.